Alright gang, updates, updates, updates. I nearly forgot to start recording this because I've been doing the Enfield for 2 weeks. I totally forgot about the Grumph, and the Grumph's up on YouTube already, so there's going to be some weird crossover between these. But yeah, I've just been doing a bit of work. Dump silencer, just checked it on the pipes. Basically, because Enfield's over there, I've moved Enfield out of the way. I thought, right, we'll have a look at this Grumph to try and get ourselves back up to date with it. And then I were about to start welding pipes up, and then I thought, oh, bloody hell, I'd get my camera out, because I said I'd record this, and I've not. So, yeah, pretty much what I've done is just double-check the pipes, got them back into where I think they should be, marked it for where I need to get some dints, because it's tight to get in and out, get them on and off. And then I checked the silencer, and the silencer's just kicking up a little bit too much. Then I've cut an angle on the end of the silencer. I'll show it you here. Like that. Cut that on end of it, and that's supposed to marry up with frame, is that angle there, and it's just sat a little bit up, so they don't line up right, so either the pipes want bending down, or I'm going to do a little bit of bodging and cut a slit in it, cut a slit in both pipes and just bend just the last little tiny bit down. That bit will go inside the silencer. The weld, where I weld it up, that'll be just on the outside of the silencer, so you'll just see it. But then I'll butt up two little bits of tube just behind back at silencer that I'll hide where I've welded it together, make it look nice and neat, nice little join. So yeah, the one I've got here now is, I say, that's Enfield. He's coming picking that up in half hour. That's got half an hour sat here. So I've got that all packed up, ready to go. As in, the pipes are fitted to it and they're on there nice and tight. Have a look at that, because it won't be on your Grumph one. You can watch that video, I'll upload that after Grumph. Then that's the original pipes. Megas are in that box. Foot pegs off this bike are in that box there, so all ready to go back to the customer. Yeah, and if you want to see that being built, just so see these exhaust pipes being bent and made and fitted, you'll have to wait a few weeks, and I'll put that video up after this video. So you're getting a bit of time travelling, because you're seeing them now before they're even finished in YouTube world. But yeah, we'll get back onto this one. That's the left-hand pipe. Wants a little bit of a dint in here. Bit of casing. This is the right-hand pipe with crossover. And I've trimmed a little bit out of that in the middle there, just to get a perfect fit. And now this is touching here on casing, on barrel there. So that wants a bit of a dint putting in it. Or a big dint putting in it, just to clear barrel as it's coming on and off. And then I'm going to weld round that. I'm just going to run a TIG weld round that in the next half an hour while I'm waiting for this guy to come and pick this up. It's just started raining outside. I'm going to have to open big door, open cage, open big door, get that out, and then carry on with this for an hour or two before I go home for my tea. And I say, yeah, I'll get camera back out. Battery's running low again, always is. I'll get camera back out and I'll film me fitting them back onto the bike. Once I've got them, I'll get that welded up, stick a dint myself again, trim them to length. It's when I hold that little focus button down, I've been trying to take a photograph. Trim them to length, put a dint in it, weld round that one, fit them back on bike, put silencer on, so you get to see what it looks like, and then make some modifications to it again from that point on. But I'll put battery on charge now, and I'll get camera out for the next bit. Right guys, we're back on. The Royal Enfield has gone back on its way to its customer. So I'm gonna do what I said I'm gonna do. I'm gonna show you this Greeves Grumph. I've had the pipes off, I've messed with them a bit. The pipes are back on, so I'm going to show you while they're back on before I pull them back off again. Have a look at this one. Right guys. Right, so this is what we've got. Pipes are back on, and they're looking just as the customer's drawn them, really. At one point, I had that silencer kicked up. You see the angle on that chain guard there? It's just running uphill nicely. That's what I wanted it to do, but the gap up here to get the tailpipe out of gets too small. I've had a go, it won't fit. It did look better being slightly swept up along its way, but now what I'm trying to do is I'm doing the opposite. I'm trying to bring it down now to try and get it to line up with this seat rail. which is difficult because the pipes have already been finished off with them angled up, so I'm having to faff a bit. So this is what it looks like. You've just seen that there, haven't you? Nice sweep, nice gap, little box with an angle cut on it, tailpipe. And this is what the customer wanted. Same thing, nice sweep, nice gap, box with an angle on it, tailpipe. It looks better in real life, doesn't it? Looks a lot better in real life. So I had a look at it round here, and there, when you're at that angle, this is what I like all my pipes to look like. That doesn't look real now. It looks like it's been sketched on, or it looks like it's been moulded out of plasticine. They don't look like two pipes. They look like too fake, don't they? So that's normally a good sign that they're spot on. It looks like they've just been, what I like my pipes look like, it looks like these have been coming out of here, molten, right? The bike's been going fast and they've just gone whoop like that, just flopped the way back, and they've just been styled by the wind. It's almost like the perfect lines, isn't it? Yeah, just been windswept. And that's basically, that is exactly what these have got. It's just like, it just wraps and hugs and formed itself to the bike, which is almost organic, I'd say. Organic's probably the right word. Like, they've just grown on there, which they have, because that's the way I make pipes. I tend to get them, they just grow on the bike. So they didn't look like that to start off with, and then the bike's helped just form them into that shape. So like I say now, that was sticking up there before to follow that chain guard. We're now just the arc's getting bigger on it, because I'm bringing that back end down, flattening it out. And the way I'm doing that is a bit of a cheat. I did think about warming them up between that line and that line and just giving them a tilt over. Tiny, just a degree's worth of bend. But I've achieved that here. Look at that, I've just slit it 3/4 of the way through, slit that one 3/4 of the way through, and then just gone, push down on it there, like that. And let's just close that gap up on them, on bottom edges of them. Hard to focus in on. You could almost see a bit of light through that one there. There you go. But it's not focusing in on it. There you go. You can see that bit of light coming through there. Basically, yeah, what I want it to do now, it wants to come down a little bit more, so I'm just going to squash on it a bit more. But this bottom one's touching together, so that wants a little bit more taken out with grinder. And then I'll be able to get that top one to close together. Which means pulling them off, putting them back on again. And then once I've got them right, I know that I can just stick them on my bench, get that to come right together, tack it, weld round it, grind it off, put it back on, give it another try, and then we should have a nicely formed set of pipes that are all following right lines. And then the next part after that will to be get this tailpipe in the right place. It's just loosely fitted at the moment, which is using the frame to hold it in place. And it's looking right, it's got that, it's like it's level as it goes around that bend there. And it finishes nicely inside of there with shocker. So it's just a bit of a guest trim, but yeah, it's finishing nice there in line with shocker. It's got a bit of a gap down back of it, you can't really see that. There you go, yeah, nice little bit of a gap there. It wants a little dint put in it here to clear that frame. But once I get that in right place, I'll just give it a tack on there and a tack on here with TIG welder. I take it off, braze it in, so it looks really nice and just nicely joined in. And then as it is, if I put a bracket from that silencer up to there, and then put a bracket between the two, I don't actually think you'd need anything to hold that together. It'll just all be stressed in the place where they won't come out. The pipes won't come out because one pipe will fight with the other one if you attach them there. And if you put that silencer, just fix it to that seat bracket there, then that can't move backwards and forwards, so there's no way that the pipes can come in or out. It won't move. It's because it's been put into a junction box. It's just highly sprung. So I think that's the way I'm going to leave it. I'm probably not going to put no springs on it or anything. Just leave it looking really, really clean. I'm probably going to have to speak to the customer about it, which means speaking to the restorer guy, get him to speak to the customer. But from there on, that looks trick as. So I'm going to leave you at that. I'm going to do all my little work on it again. I'm going to flip camera around, see my face one last time. It's going to be me for end of day. It's half five, so basically just going to have another look at this. Like I say, put a tack on the bottoms of them pipes. pull it off, put it back on again. When I come in tomorrow, but it'll look exactly the same, it'll be in the same place. But I'll be able to move on, I'll be able to tack that tailpipe on, start thinking about the brackets. Once I've got the brackets on and they've got the tailpipe welded in, that's done, pipes are finished. Because like I say, I might not spring them right like that. I'll just leave them like that. And then it'll be a case of taking the two tanks off. I need to take the petrol tank off, the oil tank off. They need a bit of sheeting in work. We need to, the customers cut the bottom of the tank out to make it fit better onto engine. They've cut the oil tank out to make it fit better into frame, just to keep it all nice and snug and nice lines going on. And he's just left big holes there, basically. He said, can you fill that in with a bit of tin? So that'll be the next job. That'll be like my final YouTube video of this, I would have thought. I'll show you the finished pipes in the next one. And then we might do another YouTube video with me doing the tanks. And then we're done. So, yeah, have a good night, everyone. And I know you probably get like that, like, five of them. Five byes in each one of these videos. Because I get to the end of the day, I do one of these videos. And I'm like, bye. But then I piece them all together. And you're just getting five of them. So I'm going to try and stop doing that. I'm going to try and stop saying, right, guys, introducing each flipping five-minute video. We'll get better, won't we? Have a good one. And that this bit, this transition's really, really bad as well. Just flick it off, Ben. Right, adios. Right, guys, we're back on today. I've just charged my battery up. Same thing, don't know if you can see me. Come and check that. Probably doing like a proper grand bad and chopping my head off. Oh, you can see that motorbike in background. Oh yeah, chopping my head off. Right guys, yeah, you can see me, right, buzzing. I've got a full battery, so we're gonna do a little video. I'm gonna just grind this off. I just thought I'd just get it out, flipping. What I've been doing, I spent all morning double checking this, taking it on, taking it off. Bit of a nightmare when you first put them on, they're tight as, and you have to fight with them like mad to try and get them on and off. And obviously you don't want the customer doing that, so I've had to put some dints in here to clear the cases, the barrels I should say. Then I've done some little alterations on there, just cut a slot in that, bent it down a little tiny bit, welded it up, put a slot in it here so it slips into the head a bit better. I'm going to grind that up. Obviously that were a modification in first place, so cutting, re-weld that bit. Just take a little tiny bit out of the middle, a little bit too long. So yeah, I'm just going to buff all that off. And then I could probably speed this up. Just clean it up and then put it all back on bike. I'll film that bit as well, putting it back on bike. So I'll shut my mouth and we can speed this section up. We'll be right back.
Right, gang.
Got that done. Yeah, that's one done. So put that on in a minute. I'll get the other one out. Really didn't need to start through that because you'd just be. That's if I slow it down. Yeah, just double check this one. Right guys, just finished a bit of brazing. I've been brazing up a little bracket, brazed on a little nut on the back. That's my next trick now, is to get that brazed on. I'll have to find it for you. We all know this don't work when I do this, but yeah, made a little bracket like that. So these 1 foot top, 1 foot bottom. Got a nice little stainless domed head nut in there, I mean bolt. Brazed the nut on the back. That's gonna go on the set of pipes. So I built them all back up again on bike, but I've got something else to do to it yet as well before I finish it off. So we'll pull it, I'll put the stand out and we'll pull it all back off, put it all back on. Basically, that's gonna sit behind the back of there. It's not zooming, it's not focusing, but you get the picture. That's gonna go on there. Then I've got, don't know where I put them, got four little bits of tube. These cut some little rings. And these little rings are gonna go one on there, slide it along the pipe, one on there, and then slide two up towards the head. Braze them on. Braze them on, basically what it does, it just makes a nice, just makes a little feature out of this where it joins into the head instead of it being an abrupt right angle. It has a little step up. And then the same with this, how it's got an abrupt right angle there. If you braze a little collar on behind, it makes a nice little stop for that to kick up against. Same with them, you know that they're in all the way when that's pushed up to the head. It also make a bit of a tighter seal, and it just makes a nice little finished off job. So what I'm gonna do, yeah, pull it all off, put them, slide them rings on the pipe, tack them on where I want them to be, and like I say, have a go at welding that bracket on there, which I mean getting TIG welder out, clamping that on the back, getting TIG welder out, tacking it on top, tacking it on the bottom, pulling it all off. I might actually braze it on there because I've had a look around the bike and there's not much there at that front end that I can burn. Like this plastic mud guard on the back, there's nothing really there that'll set on fire, so I should be able to get down back of it there with welder and just run a bit of braze on. What I'm going to do here, my battery's running low again, and this battery is the one that takes all day to charge up, so it's definitely knackered, so I'm going to have to invest in some new batteries, I think. But yeah, that's my plan. I'll see how much, don't know which way around I'm pointing that. I'll see how much charge I've got in that battery that's on there. I put this one back on charge, this one charges up a bit better. You don't need to know the ins and outs of batteries. But I'll do that, set camera up, see if we can get enough footage of me pulling this apart, putting it back together before it dies. So yeah, I'll do that now, and then I'll put it on the tripod. Right guys, we're on. So what did I say? Put them rings on, slide them down the pipes, put it all back together again, see how well it comes apart this time. It's all a bit looser than it used to be. It used to be really, really tight. I've probably spent like a couple, 4 or 5 hours just doing this. Because when I first put it on, it just didn't want to come apart. Still don't know, I need to put a bracket on here, and I don't know what I'm going to do about that, because you won't be able to wiggle that if you put a bracket on. The tailpipe's going to make it difficult as well. Do what I said, just slide that on there. Slide that on there. We can down out of the way. Get this one off. Yeah, I don't know if that's going to come off in real life. The silencer comes off now, I don't know if it will do when I've finished it. Even this is a bit of a pain to get on and off. It'll only just go. I think I've got it. There we go. Right. Collar on there. Collar on there. Right, put it back together. Get them collars slid up. Make sure, you've got to make sure everything's really, really tight. So everything's butted up nicely. Because then it won't go any further on. Obviously, once I put them rings in place, it won't go any further. So something like that. That ring won't flip and push right over there, that's annoying. That one looks alright though. Tailpipe in. And we'll have another look at it. Come and have a look at this. Looks absolutely delightful, to be honest with you. It's a really nice system. It moves about a fair bit. But once I put a bracket in between there, that'll tie them two front pipes together. They won't move around once they've been bolted together here. They're slotted inside there. They're them rings. So you see what I mean? It just gives it... That one is pushing over on the top. Which might mean... Might tack it here. Then hit it with an hammer there to try and square it up a little bit. Bottom one. Looks, they look really nice again. So what I do, just braze round them with a really fine braze. And then buff them in. Buff them in just so it's just got like a little tiny step up. It just makes it look nice, finish it off with a little bit of detail. And then same with this one here on top. Just a tiny, tiny little step up. You just blend that in. And it just makes it look like the end of a pipe instead of the it not having an end. So same on that one there. I know the customer's not going to put roses on. I'm sure it says on the thing that he's not going to put roses on it. So that's a nice little detail if you're not putting roses on. I think I might have to ask the guy that's doing it. I'll reread through the notes as well before I actually braze them on. Just in case he does want to put roses on and I've misread it. But yeah, that's what it looks like. And that's what it's going to look like, really. I'm going to, like I say, I'll just read through notes now. Get back through his reading through the book. It's about 6 pages long, this thing. Have a read through this. Just double check it's all to what he wants before welding on the brackets. Because once I've welded on the brackets, it's all fixed in place and there's not much else to do. He wanted a spring from here to there, I think. But I want to put one underneath there as well if I'm going to do that. To make it look nice, to match it up. But it's going to be tight to get a spring in there, so might scrap that off. Might scrap it off and just put a big bracket from here to there, and then that should hold it all in place, and it might not even need fastening together. That's the part that I'm toying with now. That's the debate at the moment in my head, is what do I do about that? What do I do about the brackets? Will it all come off once I've put the brackets on? And is that what the customer wants? I think that the shape, the line, the gap, the level of it all, I think that's exactly what he's probably got in mind. Probably better than what he's got in mind. But yeah, just the finishing touches now, they're all, I don't know, customer specific. It depends on what they want, yeah, really. So I just need to make sure I do the last bits, because I could ruin it just by doing these last couple of bits. So I'm going to think about it. I say I'll have a read through that. Take it all off, put it all back on again. Same old, same old. Right guys, quick update. Nothing to report. I spoke to the guy last night. He's happy with everything I've been doing. The brackets, them little rings I'm going to put on, them little collars. He was fair adamant that I needed to check the chain guard and the silencer. The cutout I put in the silencer to clear the chain guard. He was like, you sure that's in the right place? Were you sure it'll clear? And I couldn't check it while it were on bench, because basically because I had it all strapped down, so there was no way I could squash it down on back, especially not on a big floppy bench. So what I've done, I've just dropped it down on floor. I'm waiting for a customer to drop me off like another Yoshimura job with 4-into-1 sand bent pipes for like an endurance racer type bike. That's been at Maxton. It's been being set up at Maxton, having suspension set up, so he's picking that up, bringing it here. So I'm just doing a bit of a move around. So I've dropped this Grumph down, it's behind me. It's down here on floor. I've had a good jump up and down on it, and there's loads of clearance. So I'm gonna crack on with that. I only needed it up on bench to set out levels, so I could get out level, you know, level at pipe right, while I was stood at eye level. And now I've got that set, I can actually finish it off down on the floor, because all I need to do is just braze these rings on. Braze them on. Braze the tailpipe in place there. And then put a bracket from there to there somehow. That's all I need to do to finish that off. So, yeah, I don't need to wire it up anymore. That's set at that level. So my next thing is now, get the benches there. I'm going to swivel it round because it were the wrong way round. Then, wait, Mark, it's the bit right way around again. No, it's not. I'm putting this big beamer on it. This big beamer wants some endurance pipes put on it. Some enduro pipes, should say. Some 6-day trials bike pipes, so there'll be... I've done one before, just two pipes up this side. Swing that other pipe over the top of casings. That one across there. Run a little 2-into-1, don't back at shocker. That's next on the bench. I need to clear up some space to get another bike in. So, get that, spin that round, put BMW on the bench, stick it back over there in corner, get this one out, put it in front of it, maybe put the bike that's coming in between them while I finish that one off. So leave that one where it is, put the bike that's coming there, then swizz that one in front of it, chain them all together. Job done. So yeah, I'll report back when that turns up. You'll get to see what's third in line, but yeah, that's next in line. It's a bit, I've got a lot of time to do that one again. The customer's sound and he just said, just take your time with it. So that one will be like this Grumph. I'll be doing it in between the jobs. So this bike that's turning up next, I don't know what the date is for that one. Could be a rush time. It's a race bike, so it's probably likely that it's got a bit of a rush time on it. But then I've got a similar 4-into-1 Yoshimura style to do for a bike shed job. Bike shed shows in May, end of May. So that one will definitely be a rush job. So that BMW is likely, it's gonna take about the same amount of time. That won't be done until the end of May because I'll have to squeeze these two Yoshimura jobs around it, if you get me. So I'll be doing that. That'll just be on back burner while I do the other two, which is exactly what I'm same as what I've done with this Grumph. I've done that Royal Enfield while doing the Grumph, and I've done that Norvin while doing the Grumph. So basically what it were, I bent the pipes a couple of weeks ago, made the silencer after that, yes, made the silencer a week ago. Been doing that for about 3 weeks while I've been doing the other two jobs. But yeah, now it's coming to, I just get that finished off now because there's only a day or two left in it. Probably 3 days because I've got to take petrol tank off, weld all that up, take oil tank off, weld all that up. Could be three days tops in that, and then depending on what this guy says now about this Yoshimura bike, is I'll have a jump on that straight away, or I'll make a start on the beamer. All depending on tooling as well, to be honest with you. That beamer's going to want 1.5-inch pipes on it, so if this endurance race wants 1.5-inch pipes on, I'll do the pipes at the same time and then pick which one I'm going to carry on working on, which will probably be the endurance racer, just because it'd be more time critical. I don't have to do silencer on it as well, so it's not as big a job as doing the beamer. But make the pipes while the tooling's on. Maybe that might be a possibility to do the next, that bike shed show bike as well. Just leave that tooling on for a month, say. Get it set up nicely and just keep bending them off. So, I'm going to go again for a little bit. Clean up workshop for a while. I'm just waiting for this guy to come from Chester, I think. Chester, Warrington, something like that. That's where Maxton is. That's it. I'm just going to potter around, remove everything about, and then we'll have a look at this Grumph again this afternoon.